Hello, welcome back. In the last episode, we ended up going through the forest, and now we get to go to Little Slugger. Let's see. Uh-oh. Dr. Fetus, you douchebag. No! Oh my god. Okay. This part, Dr. Fetus is in a chainsaw machine walker. Oh. And you got to run away from him, and all the little squirrels are actually running right into the saws. This is horrible. But also, you have to give credit to the music in this game. This is quite epic music, and I especially love the... I'll let you know when it comes up. Here. Yeah. Yep. In, and... over. Ah! That was the end, too! Oh. Okay, here we go. Up, there we go. And we gotta get away from that chainsaw thing. Look at all the poor little squirrels. They're running into their doom. Oh, I'm running into my doom. Ooh, up, over, and again. Man, if you want to have, like, a really good weekend, you pop in some Super Meat Boy. Believe it or not, the guy who made this game, God, I wish I remember his name because he's like super awesome at his work. I love most every game that he made, but I haven't played all of his stuff, and I need to alleviate that soon, but I played most of his work. I played this and I played... Binding of Isaac, which I should probably play a little bit of for my next one. In fact, that's what I'm going to do on my list, is that the next one I'm going to be doing Binding of Isaac. Binding of Isaac is an awesome dungeon crawler. Roguelike. But, I forgot how I got onto this topic, but I'm going to continue with my current thought. I don't even remember what my current thought was. Binding of Isaac. Binding of Isaac. We'll do that one next. But this is what this game does, is that it makes you super focused, and it sort of drives you insane. There we go. That was close. Oh, that one actually got me. Okay, here we go. Yep. Ow. Maybe I gotta just cool my jets a little. Gotta remember to do the baby hops. Baby hops. It's like hops for beer, that really weak beer. Baby hops. And, every single time it's my fault. Well, like, you can say that about anything else, but, you never feel like you have a cheap death. Like, everything is just designed perfectly to sort of... There we go. There we go. Up, over. There. Okay, guys, we won. We did it. Screw you, Dr. Fetus. Damn it! He took our girl, that douchebag. Yeah, there's a dead squirrel. Oh, there's... so many dead squirrels. This game also has plenty of references to many things. This one is the Native American crying at the litter that is all over the land, and he looks around and he has a single tear. I don't know if you guys remember.
Chapter complete!
Chapter complete!
Okay, we didn't make it to any Dark Worlds. We got 3 bandages, warps, 2 out of 4. But of course, this is over my previous playthrough. My god, look at Meat Boy. He's just so banged up. Poor guy. Alright, let's continue. Okay, the hospital. And this is a Castlevania reference. I have never played Castlevania. In fact, I played so few iconic NES games. It was most likely, I had my fair share. I really enjoyed the NES. There we go with Meat Boy. Okay, looks like we're in a dark place filled with what looks like to be used syringes. So that's awesome. Just all over the place. Yes, of course, just jump right over Bandage Girl. Ah, bleep, whoop, blop. Beep, boop, blop. There we go. A plus. Okay, apparently there is now needles going through these areas. Oh, 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 can we get that bandage? Ah. No, we can't. This is what the game does to you. Now, with this game in particular, I have to have a timer, because if I don't, I'm going to be going on forever just doing the same things over and over again. The prime definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again with the intent of something different. Bandage get. Doing the same thing over and over again, intending different results. Now I'm gonna have to admit, that was pure luck. Okay. Oh, gotta do the baby hops. Gotta do the baby hops. Boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. 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 What the hell was that noise? I swear, in really good games like this, you tend to make sounds that you never knew that you were capable of making. It pisses you off just enough that you want to keep on doing it again. Nah. Hey, that's what the game's all about. Like, you can actually make a drinking game out of this. Of course, you will die at this, and I think some of my friends ended up saying that they do that, is that every time that you die, you gotta take just a sip of a drink. If you think you're awesome, try playing this game drunk, and then you get progressively worse. It's like, I remember, me and my friends, we would have this drinking game with the new Super Mario Brothers on the DS. And any time that we die, we gotta take a drink. There we go. That's how it's done. We ended up getting smashed in about an hour. I should have probably saw that. That was probably awesome. Okay, what do we got here? Oh, we got fans. And we're learning how fans work. Okay. Fans usually don't work. They spend too much time oddling a... Nah, I'm just kidding. Coming for me. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Ooh. That was a bit fun. Ooh, ooh. Yeah. Dude, He ended up punching her so hard, she ended up... Whew, that's intense. There we go. Ooh, that's done. Oh god, there was needles there. Oh, oh. Well, that's not how it's done. Making noises doesn't help, but it's like instinctual. It's almost like sometimes... If you ever played any kind of controller-based games, sometimes you hit the jump button harder, thinking that you jump higher, but that's not the case. What the hell is this jello doing on the walls? Okay, apparently... Okay, the jello kills you. Or blood clots. Yep, they definitely kill you. Okay, and then we'll go up, up, up. Ooh, see what I said about noises that you never knew that you were possible to make it? I just made one right there. A+. That's quite impressive. I'm proud of me on that one. Well, I'm going to have to call that an episode there. So thank you for watching, and in the next episode, we will start on to the next level, which is this one. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.